Hi, this is a new video that I'm making for a special upload for my 1,500 subscribers on YouTube. And so I decided I would make a new video with some updates and a little bit more information about my music. I actually had done a video before with that was about a 30 minutes long video, but I decided to redo a new one because the first one was very I was not really clear when talking. Sometimes it's just because of it's a webcam too, so sometimes I talk and then I start you know, I don't pronounce right, and it's very hard to understand. And I also looked a little bit in a bad mood in the first video, because those videos are hard to make for me, I find, just talking alone in my studio room in front of a camera. And so yeah, I thought I would do another one, take another try at it, and hopefully that one will be better. So where should I start? Well, first of all, the main reason I'm making this video is because I really want to just tell everyone that is looking at this video right now that really thank you for watching my videos and listening to my music on YouTube. And it's really, really, really nice for me to realize that my channel has grown really big to that amount of people. And by the time I had started making this video, it has already climbed to I think 1,530 subscribers, which is really big and really quick too. Yeah, the thing is, sometimes either I'm working at my job or something, and then, you know, or just having a bad day, and then I go check my comments on my Gmail account, on my YouTube account, and then I just see all those comments of people saying, you know, that they really enjoy my music, and it cheers me up a lot to see that. And sometimes it's hard to be keeping doing, like, I like to do music a lot, and I know I will keep doing it no matter what, but it's just whatever you see that other people are really, really appreciating what you do, it just makes me feel more like I'm doing, you know, it's encouraging, and it feels more like you're doing your, like, it's part of what you do. So that really makes a difference, and I just want everyone to know that. And because, yeah, I remember whenever I started uploading music on YouTube, it was really hard because I was not familiar with YouTube at all, and it was really hard to get followers, because whenever you start and you have nothing, you just start from nothing, you just have some music and uploading it, and it really spread over that first week, first year, and then, you know, it just keeps growing now pretty much by itself. And I realized too, as my YouTube channel grew, I also start learning more about how to create my music and how to do my piano playing or guitar playing, and so many different styles. And it's always a pleasure to share my music, and the more I share, the more I want to do a new type of music. So yeah, I really wanted to tell you that, so you know, but you probably know anyways that I really appreciate that. And I like to reply to comments as well, just so you know, for me, it's because I really appreciate it, so I always take the time to reply to comments because I enjoy reading them. So if I take the time to read them, I take the time to reply to them. So yeah, so this is a special video, and I hope I won't look seem to be really, like, sometimes I find that I look a little bit depressed in my videos. But I think it's just because it's hard to do the videos like that. So yeah, what should I say now besides that? I'm wearing my sweater that is the one that you can see in really some of my almost first video uploads. Maybe like even that was 1 year ago. It's you probably have seen it. There's a piano piece that's called The Trick, which is one that has kind of a lot of views. And I'm wearing that that same sweater. So yeah, I got that for my video now. There's a little hole in there. I love it. So yeah. But besides sweaters, what should I say? Yeah, I have some little facts there about me and my music and the way I create and all those things. So first thing is that you probably have noticed that I always reply to comments, but whenever I reply to my comments, I always reply with little smiley faces in all my reply comments. Like almost all the time there's gonna be a little smiley face at the end. And I didn't really realize that, but after a while I said, yeah, you know, I like to put them everywhere, but yeah, that's a thing. And so I improvise every day as well. Like I will play music every day. I don't think there's ever one day where I didn't do music since the last 2 years or so. Usually I have my little moment in the evening or late at night where I play on the keyboard, and usually in the morning I play the piano. Sometimes I play the guitar more often. I have found that there are moments where I play more the guitar, and other moments I play the piano more often. But these two are my favorite instruments. What else? I have written down some information so I don't forget. Over the last 2 years that I've been on YouTube, I have done about 25 collaborations with other composers. So I would say even 25 and over. So I have done a lot of collaborations with the same pianist, and then collaborations with other various composers from around the world. You know, for either vocals, instruments, songwriting. And I really like to do collaborations. I find it's I never had anyone add anything to my compositions, but I love to add things to other people's music. It's a very interesting challenge because I like to listen to the piece and try to see what really goes into the music. I don't really try. Of course, I use my music style. I apply my music style to the original track, but I don't just, you know, go and try just do whatever. I just, you know, what I mean is that I really listen carefully and I will go by the emotions of the track, or really try to find what you cannot hear in the track, but try to make it stronger with an instrument. So yeah, it's hard to explain, but yeah, I really like to do collaborations, and it's also interesting to see that, you know, everyone makes music differently. So each time that I work with a track from someone, it's always different. It's never the same thing, and that's really makes it really interesting. So I'm glad I had the opportunity to do that. It's really great, and also even at first it really helped me to get more confident about my voice and my playing and all that. So it really helped me, and I hope I will continue to collaborate with other composers on more music. What else? So far, right now on my YouTube channel, I have 266 videos, I believe, or with this one maybe 267. And on that there is probably about 240 videos which are my original compositions. The rest would be just video mixes or video logs, or I don't know, whatever you call it, live videos like this, or just double videos with two different versions of a track. So I probably have about 240 original compositions right now on my YouTube channel. My YouTube channel is where I keep most of my music. I don't really upload music to anywhere else. But I have recently created a new SoundCloud account, and I will give you the link in the description. And that account will just be for me to upload really quick improvisations. No big soundtrack, something that is really good, just the quick recordings or some work in progress of a track or something. So this SoundCloud account, you can check it out if you like, but it really will be like, you know, looking somewhere and just dig in and try to find something that is good, because there will be some music that is really crappy and some music that is better, but it's not it's really quickly done compositions. That's why I don't want to put it in my YouTube channel, because if I start uploading all the music I do, there will be uploads every day, and you know, the good music, the one that's that I really I'm more proud about, will probably get lost between the quick improvisations. But I think it's still nice to keep the improvisations, and that's why I created that account. And I will not really be active other than uploading music. I don't think I will, you know, do follow back on SoundCloud to other people. It's really just for me to keep my music there. So yeah, so if you want to check it out, you're really welcome to do so and see if there's any music you like there. Another fact about me is that I never go back to my videos like this, the ones where I talk. Never, ever, ever. Once it's published, I more try to forget about it than go back and watch it again. I really don't like to see them back, because I always find that, you know, either I'm not, you know, I don't look like I look bored, or I shouldn't have said that, or I should have said this, and you know how it is. I know if some of you already had done those videos, you probably know what I mean. But yeah, never go back to watching them. So, but I'm glad when people appreciate it, because it encouraged me to keep making them. So yeah. What else? Well, I know some of you probably know that I have a band. Another band, it's with my sister, and we play Celtic music. The band's name is Cosan, and I play guitar and I do step dancing, and my sister she plays the violin and she sings, and I also sing. So we do traditional Irish songs, we have one song that we sing in Gaelic, and we really, really love that. I really like to do shows also, live performances on stage. It's really different from what you experience just sitting in your studio and creating recording music alone there. whenever you're on stage and just play music, and you know, the public really likes it, and it really builds an energy that I really like. So I'm really glad that we have the band, and that's pretty much how I started my music, actually, that I started, you know, getting interested in music a lot. We had the band for about, I think, maybe 8 years, 7, 8 years. And yeah, we still keep going, so I really like that. It's nice. And but I will also put the link in the video description, so you can check our pages also there. And talking about that, I will soon finish the album. We have created an album this winter. We have recorded about 10 songs, 10 of our of music, 10 tracks. And I have also designed an album cover for that. And I really just need to finish it, so one song has to be probably remixed. And then I need to just put the proper name track on them, and then it will be probably ready. So when we release the album, I will try to maybe put a demo here on my YouTube channel, so you guys can listen to some of it. And I'll try to have the album be available on iTunes, wherever is the best place, so people can buy it. But we also are going to make physical albums, so hard CDs that we can sell whenever we play at places. So when people want to buy the albums, they can. So I will do that, and I will be a bit busy with doing that as soon as possible. That's really important to get done. But I might keep you updated on that. What else I have to see here? So I was also thinking about making also an album on my side, just with my music. I just feel like doing that lately, so usually that's how it works with me. I just need to wait till, you know, I feel like doing a new album release. And the new album release will be it will probably be music with a piano, a bit of piano, and a lot of vocals. So I would just put the tracks together and make either a long playlist, like, I don't know, an hour of relaxing music, or a half an hour video. But I would like to also release a new album. I think it would be nice to do that. Something else, something I can tell you is that I was actually homeschooled. So I had my, I did school at home, and a lot of the time, especially a bit later, I start to get used to go in my books and do my homeworks and do my own lessons. And so I think this really helped me with later learning music. Whenever I started learning music, I was really just taking it on my own, even though I had people showing me at first some really, really basic things. But I would really go by myself. Example, for the piano, I would go by myself and just play each chord, trying to find what sounds good. And just every morning I would just play, going up the scale with the chords. And just because of the challenge of wanting to learn how to play it. And with the guitar, it's also, well, it's the first instrument that I learned how to play. It was the same. I would just go, I had those chord charts. So these you can even find on the internet. They tell you where to put your fingers on the neck of the guitar. And you can play, you can learn how to play the chords. And so I would have those little cards there, and I would just try to play all the chords, and then change chords and put my fingers at the right place. And it takes a lot of time to learn to an instrument, and also some people have asked me, you know, like, they want to learn by themselves and they really don't know where to start. And I don't really remember exactly how it was for me, but I know that whenever I started the wish list, it's a lot of work. It's not going to be easy at first, because you have to teach both your mind, like how to get used to know exactly. Example, if you play the guitar, you have to know exactly where you're going to put, which strings you're gonna press. And at first you have no idea, so you have to look on a piece of paper and then check and put your fingers the same place where it tells you to. And then play it. And then because your muscles and your hands are still weak, because some muscles will have to get stronger, because you're not used to do that certain movement. So you have to train both your mind to know, to without having to look, it will know automatically where to go. And also because your muscles will get developed over time, whenever they get stronger, it won't be painful, it won't be like really hard to press on the strings. But that takes time. It's like anything that you would do, like running or anything at all. You need to take that time to train to be able to do it, and it won't go faster. It has to take time. So I find that's something that you have to go through and just not give up at first and say, no, you know, I can't do it, or it's painful in my arm. And you really have to keep going at it, and you know, it will come one day. I don't really exactly remember how long it took me before being able to change, you know, chords really fast on guitar, but probably a few months at least, I would say. And also the tip of your fingers will get really, the skin on tip of the fingers when you play guitar gets harder. So at first it's not like that, so it's really painful whenever you press the strings on the guitar. And then after a while it's going to get harder, and then it won't hurt anymore. So yeah, even with the piano, I find doing the chords, whenever you have to put your hand wide like this, you know, and then press and move your fingers, you really have to practice it often, so you get good muscles in your hands, so it doesn't hurt anymore. And also, while you do that, you will associate each note with a sound. So when I improvise, either on a guitar, piano, or any instrument, the thing is that because I play it so often, I know if I look at a chord, put my hand on certain notes, I kind of hear in my mind how it's going to sound like before I play it. So if I know that this chord sounds like that, then I know where to move to, or do a melody, I know which notes to go to make the melody that I have in my mind. So the more you play, the more you know exactly which chord sounds like. So then you can play pretty much anything that you have in your mind. The thing that was really hard at first is that you have a melody and you want to play it, but you have no idea which notes are making which sound. And same with the guitar, which string is making which sound, where to put your fingers on the fret. So it can be a little bit really hard at first and depressing. My camera's getting all white. Oops. It can be very hard and depressing at first. But you really have to keep going if you want to be able to play music, and it will come for sure. But yeah, the one thing that I find really helped also, for me anyways, is that whenever you try to play something, and then it happens that you know, you get frustrated and it doesn't work, I wouldn't stop at this moment and just put my instrument away. I used to just keep going and keep doing whatever I was doing or trying to do the chord right. And then whenever you have it right and it sounds good and you're really happy about what you've done, then you put your instrument away. Because if you stop whenever you're struggling, what you will remember after is that you didn't really like the last time you played the instrument. And that will just take away your joy of playing that instrument. So it's the same thing whenever I was learning to do juggling. I will never stop whenever I was dropping a ball on the ground or whenever I was not able to do it. I would do something simple instead and something I could do and then stop. And I find that really helps you to be more enthusiastic about the instrument or about the learning process. But also, whenever you learn an instrument, I think instead of trying to play not often but for long periods of time, you should play often for short periods of time. So don't get frustrated or don't force yourself whenever you don't feel like it's going anywhere. And instead, you know, take a break often and just do a little bit at a time. And I think that's a good advice that worked for me. And I think it will work for everyone else. I hope anyways. But that just is little tips. So what else I could tell in this video? But nothing really new happened until last time I did a video, I don't think so. No huge projects in the making right now. I have lots of music that I'm interested in doing, and also albums I want to release. Right now I'm working also part-time. I'm working a part-time job, so a few days a week, but I still can't have time to do music. I'm not as long as I still can do music, then I'm fine. And I still have the opportunity to work on music projects. So it's really good. But I keep making music all the time, of course, and I don't have really ideas for a huge project. You know, I do lots of collaborations and sometimes I work on projects which people ask me to do. But I think that's pretty much it, actually. I'm just wondering what else I could say. But I think I've said pretty much everything. So if you have any questions about, you want to do music or you want to learn how to play an instrument, and you have questions to ask, just comment in this video and ask me, and I can do my best to reply to you or give you some guidances if I can, or for anything else. I really like to help people out with music, and I really like to talk about music. So whatever questions that you have, really just feel free to send me a message or just put a comment in the video, and it will be my pleasure to reply. So I guess that's pretty much it. I don't think this video was better than the first one, actually. And I probably really would like to tell you guys more, but I really can't think of much right at the moment. But it's getting blue now. The main reason why I wanted to make a video is really to tell you thank you for following my work and my YouTube channel, and really welcome to the new ones that just subscribed lately. And if you don't know, I speak French originally, so that's why I have an accent. And for those who have been following my work since the beginning, or really for since 1 year or a few months, I really want to thank those people for having done that and just keeping listening to my music, following my progress and following my journey through the music. And so I guess I've said everything. And really thank you for watching this video, and I hope that it was somehow a little bit interesting. And I wish you a great day, and hopefully I'll see you in my next video upload. Goodbye. Hello everyone, this is watching my video. Hi everyone, hello everyone, this is my second video, no,